Leaders of sustainability and innovation clinched top recognition at the 6th annual Nordic Awards. Nordcham Philippines, with the embassies of Denmark, Norway, Sweden in Manila, and the embassy of Finland in Kuala Lumpur and the Philippines-Norway Business Council, recently held its 6th edition of the annual Nordic Awards night. Nordcham Philippines is the largest Nordic chamber of commerce in Asia. Well, with us now for more in the studio is Yuna Salin, the executive director of the Nordic Chamber of Commerce in the Philippines. Good to have you with us, Yulin, and welcome to the program.
Thank you, Kathy.
So I'm looking at the categories there, and it appears that you've really put a focus on sustainable development goals in each of the categories. Why?
Yeah, well, that of course is something that we feel very strongly about in the Nordic countries, apart from the innovation that is sort of the second pillar of what we want to recognize here. So we want to make sure that in each of the five award categories, we also tie the categories and the criteria heavily to the UN Sustainable Development Goals and the Agenda 2030.
And that includes Nordic values that you stand for, which encompass innovation, sustainability, equality, education, and growth. So what can Philippine companies learn from these Nordic values when they do business here?
So, of course, if you look at why we do the awards night and want to put focus into these particular areas, it's really about recognizing companies who excel in these topics. And that means then, from the sustainability perspective, that companies put focus on environment, but also into the stakeholder relations, to the code of conduct. So it's quite a wide grasping category and make sure that all the different aspects of sustainability are taken into account. Now, if we then look at a couple of the other categories, such as the growth category, there of course employment generation as well as revenue growth are important drivers of the economy. So that's why we want to recognize that, both in the large company segment as well as with the small and medium-sized enterprises. And if we then look at the Outstanding Employer of the Year, there it's really about talent development and taking gender equality at the workplace into account. It's about providing the opportunities for people to grow, become the best they can at the workplace. And providing those opportunities equally across the board. And then finally, the innovation, that's really about technology on the one hand, but also sustainability of those new innovations, and then how to take those into global success. So I think that's, as a whole, something that we feel very strongly about coming from the Nordics and want to recognize in companies who operate here locally in the Philippines as well.
Let's put some names to those categories, because pretty interesting that H&M Philippines clinched the Corporate Sustainability Company of the Year Award. Why did you choose H&M Philippines, a company in fast fashion, and talking about sustainability at the same time?
Sure. So of course, like, what goes into how we recognize these companies is a process of companies first nominating themselves or being nominated by others, and then providing supporting documentation that responds to the criteria that we are looking for. And then we have our board of judges that consists of the Nordic ambassadors as well as Philippine private sector representatives, who would then go through these nominations and rank the companies to come out with the eventual winners and finalists. So that means that in the case of H&M, when we look at what we were after in the corporate sustainability category, as mentioned, environment, also human rights and working conditions, as well as then the sort of stakeholder and community engagement as a whole, H&M came out on top with their operations here in the Philippines to to warrant them taking home the award.
Yeah, you know, interesting that H&M CEO Carl Johan Persson said in a Bloomberg interview he is concerned that growing awareness about sustainability will be bad for the fast fashion industry and the economy. From the perspective of the Nordic Chamber here in the Philippines, how would you reconcile the move towards carbon neutrality and the fact that there will be short-term job losses in the process?
Yeah, I think well, everyone talks about circular economy these days, right? No matter what industry you're in. So it's a question of, again, no matter what sector you come from, to look into how to reinvent or how to adapt, how to become responsible and what kind of change then that requires in ensuring employment generation and sustainability. So yeah, it's a constant sort of redefinition of what we do and who we are as companies and how to reinvent depending on what the environment sort of dictates.
I'm taking a closer look at the list, and not all those recognized are purely of Nordic origins. In fact, one of the finalists is homegrown integrated microelectronics. That's a Philippine conglomerate Ayala Corporation subsidiary, recognized for three things: for sustainability, innovation, and growth. So what can other Filipino firms learn from these strengths?
Yeah, again, so it's really a question of, like, when we see companies doing well in these areas that go back to our Nordic values, we want to highlight and encourage companies to live by those values. So we really want to encourage companies, no matter what the nationality is, to put focus and emphasis into being innovative, being a responsible corporate citizen, being sustainable, providing employment opportunities equally across the board, IMI would be a great example of such a company here in the Philippines who puts focus into these areas and through that. Then got recognized at this year's edition of the awards night.
Now that you mentioned innovation, I did get to interview a finalist here, not for the awards, but for a show, the Danish conglomerate Konovate. I mean, it provides low-cost housing, and it does so in emerging economies, and it started with the Philippines. So how was that recognized in the space that it does business in? And it does other businesses in its home country. It's a conglomerate there, buildings and huge structures, not really low-cost housing.
Sure. Well, I think it's also a good example of a company partnering locally, first of all, and then finding what is the opportunity for such a foreign entrant to come in and be part of the growth story that the Philippine economy has been enjoying. So I think that's one reason. Now, the other reason, they were part of the growth category, I think, in the SME. So of course, through the local operations, as a recent investment, they were in a good spot to compete in that category. And then, as a whole, on the innovation side of things. Innovation can be part of, like, not only technology but also into the business model. So I think those are some of the aspects that should be highlighted when talking about them as a finalist.
All right. Well, thank you so much for taking us through the winners and the finalists in the Nordic Awards. Appreciate the time. Yuna Selin of the Nordic Chamber of Commerce here in the Philippines.